5, 4, 3, 2.
One team. Hey Red Hawks, today is Tuesday, November 4th, 2019. I'm Maddie Neese.
And I'm Catherine Stanley.
Welcome back to Today at the Creek.
Please stand for the pledge, followed by the moment of silence.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Good morning, Docs. I'm Aiden Von Lowe, today in history, and let's see what happened on November 5th. In 1930, Sinclair Lewis becomes the first American to win a Nobel Prize in Literature for his novel, Babbitt. In 1940, FDR is re-elected for his third term. And in 1994, George Foreman becomes the oldest heavyweight champion. Today is also National Donut Day. Now back with Maddie and Catherine with today's announcements.
Applications for next summer's Governor's School are now available online. To be eligible to apply for this highly competitive summer program, students must currently be in 10th or 11th grades. Applications can be found at the Tennessee Department of Education website under the Instructions tab. Students must submit their completed applications to their counselor no later than November 15th.
Attention all 11th and 12th graders. The ASVAB test will be given on Thursday. This test is free. Students need to see Ms. Fergus to sign up. The ASVAB is a great career assessment tool, and the student does not need to go into the military if they take the test. See a counselor for more information. Now to sports with Maddox and Jacob.
Good morning, Redhawks. I'm Maddox.
And I'm Jacob.
And welcome to your Sturge Creek Sports Report. The Titans did all they could on defense this past Sunday, but it wasn't enough to stop Christian McCaffrey from running all over them as the Panthers won 30-20.
MTSU could not get a win streak going as they fell to Charlotte on Saturday, 34-20.
Vanderbilt took a conference loss on Saturday as they fell to South Carolina, 24-7.
The Vols made it two in a row as they took down UAB, 30-7.
Lamar Jackson and the Ravens handed the Patriots their first loss on Sunday with a final score of 37-20. This now leaves the 49ers as the only unbeaten team in the NFL.
The Grizzlies fell 1-4 on Saturday as they lost to the Suns, 114-105.
The swim team competed against Blackman this past Saturday. The girls fell 383.5 to 268.5, and the boys tied 385 to 385. We had the higher total score with a score of 768.5 to their 514.5.
If you're interested in track, please stop by Coach Davenport's room 603 to sign up for the sign-up info sheet. This applies to everyone, even if you're currently in a different sport.
The girls' bowling team will take on Warren County today at the Smyrna Bowling Center. The boys will take on Laverne today, also at the Smyrna Bowling Center. Both matches start at 4.
Congratulations to the female JROTC Raider team. These ladies dominated all Rutherford County JROTC Raider teams and are the Rutherford County 2019-2020 Raiders champions.
Our Lady Red Hawks soccer team will take on Ravenwood tomorrow at 2 in the state tournament. Make sure to get your permission slip signed so you can be there to support your Lady Red Hawks.
Your Redhawks varsity football team fell to Smyrna last Friday with a final score of 24-21. They look to bounce back strong, though, as they will take on Ravenwood this Friday in the first game of the playoffs.
Now back to Catherine and Maddie.
There will be a Europe 2021 interest meeting on November 7th at 6:30 in the SCHS library. Experience the world for a fraction of the typical cost through group educational travel with Education First. This makes a great graduation gift, addition to a college application, and an experience to open your world to international careers and culture. Contact Dr. Risto or Madame LeDuc for more information.
The first National Honor Society meeting of the year will be on November 12th in the lecture hall during ICU. This meeting is open to both seniors who were inducted last year and juniors who will be inducted later in the semester. Please see Ms. Wasson, Ms. Deshala, or Ms. Norris if you have any questions. Now for the weather with Samuel.
Hey, Stewart Street. I'm Samuel Nicholson. Here's the weather. Today we have a high of 61 degrees and a low of 35 degrees. There's a high of 53 degrees after school, and it's mostly sunny. Tomorrow we have a high of 67 degrees and a low of 44 degrees. There'll be a high of 59 degrees after school, and it'll be mostly sunny. Now back to Maddie and Catherine.
Attention seniors, SCTV has begun the process of creating the Class of 2020 slideshow. This will be shown at Senior Awards Night, Moving Up Pep Rally, and will be a part of the graduation video. Please send your pictures to stewartscreektv@gmail.com as soon as possible. For more information, contact a senior member of the SCTV staff.
That's all for today at the Creek. Have a great day, Red Hawks, and remember we are
one team.